there is a disease called X-linked immunodeficiency, which is found in 1 in 100,000 to a million live births.
And it basically leaves patients without the ability to fight infection. More commonly, the public would refer to this as bubble boy disease.
These patients had to be kept alive by basically sequestering them in these plastic bubbles because they have no immune system. And therefore, the only way to keep them alive was by not allowing them any exposure to any outside pathogens of any kind. What we did is we got cells from a patient that had this disease, and we converted them to what is known as iPS stem cells. These are basically cells produced in the lab that can then produce any other type of cell that the patient might require for a therapy. We have corrected the genetic mutation that causes the disease in this patient, and then gone ahead to produce one type of the immune cells that this patient is missing. And the hope is that we can use those cells for blood transfusion for these patients that will help them manage and treat the disease, which is otherwise incurable and terminal in these very young infants.
A stem cell is a very useful research tool because we can propagate these indefinitely in a dish in the laboratory, and they also have the capacity to become any cell in the whole body. So now we have a cell type that we can use to generate, in theory, an unlimited number of cells that could potentially cure a patient. So for this particular study, we focused on taking these stem cells and changing them into immune cells.
So one of the holy grails of the field is to be able to make a stem cell which is capable of making all our blood cells and all our immune cells. We have come very close. We can make all the cells which are involved to make the blood. But we haven't quite learned as yet to make all the cells involved in the immune system. That will have an enormous impact on an enormous number of diseases. Well, now we have come one step closer.